Methods of cooking. Moist heat method, boiling. With his mother's advice, Jim has gone to see Mrs. Tanga, a Qatarese who works at Tamu Hotel. At the entrance, Jim wonders whether to go in or turn back and go home. Before he can make up his mind, a tall woman rushes towards him. He is relieved to see the lady smiling warmly at him.
Hey, mister! You must be James. Your mother called this morning saying you wanted to see me. I am Mrs. Tanga.
Hello, Mrs. Tanga. Yes, I am James, but many people like to call me Jim. I like it too. I was wondering if I could steal a few minutes of your time.
It has to be very interesting. Otherwise, I will have you thrown out in a huff. Ah, just kidding. Come with me. So, what do you want to know? Foods we cook here?
Actually, how you cook the foods is of my main interest.
Oh, here we are finally. This is my office. Are you planning to be a cook someday, Jim?
Perhaps, but for now, I just want to pass my KCSE.
Fair enough. Have a seat. All right. Here, we apply various cooking methods. But first, tell me why food should be cooked.
Easy to make food taste good, soft, and easy to chew. Plus, cooking kills germs that can cause food poisoning.
Good for a start. Cooking also makes food look more appealing or good looking, as well as making it last longer.
Oh, cooked food lasts long, but how?
Cooking kills enzymes that cause food spoilage. As I mentioned before, cooking ways are one too many. To ease your burden, let's group them into two large categories: moist and dry heat methods. But before we can say much, let's find out why you would prefer one method over the other. Wanna go first?
The type of food, I guess.
Correct. You need also to consider the person the food is intended for, like, is it a child? The sick, or an expectant mother, or even a healthy person just like yourself. Plus, you want to ensure the available time, fuel, and cooking equipment is adequate for the method you choose. What do you say, Jim?
I think I'm just where I need to be.
Glad to hear that. So, where do you suggest we start?
If you're talking about cooking methods, then I think we should start with the moist heat cooking methods. In fact, I have an idea which methods might fall in this category.
Try me.
Boiling, stewing, steaming, and frying. Am I correct?
Wow, you named all of them absolutely correctly.
I looked at the chart on the wall behind you.
Hey, that's cheating. Anyway, let's get down to business. Boiling involves cooking food completely dipped in bubbling water at 100 degrees Celsius. It takes a short time and suitable for cooking meat, poultry, potatoes, and cassava.
But how do you ensure the boiled food does not lose taste or color?
That's simple. Obey rules regarding boiling of foods. Different foods are boiled in different ways, as we shall discover shortly. For example, to retain the taste, color, shape, and nutrients, avoid overcooking boiled foods. Vegetables should be boiled in just enough water and at least about serving time to preserve nutrients.
Sometimes when my mom cooks vegetables, they turn brownish or yellowish. Why?
I am assuming you are referring to green vegetables. Well, to retain the green color, you should cook the vegetables in salted boiling water. Plus, the cooking pan should be covered while boiling the food. Before cooking root vegetables, cut them into even sizes, put in cold water, then heat to boil.
I know it sounds silly, but which ones are root vegetables?
Foods such as yams, beets, turnips, carrots, garlic, ginger, and so on. They are vegetables that grow underground, and it is their roots that we eat.
Okay, you are good. Anyway, for me, I would cook beef the same way you boil root vegetables. Hope that's right.
That's a poor way to cook meat. After cutting meat into relatively equal sizes, boil water first before immersing them. This is in order to ensure the juices are retained. Once the food boils to 100 degrees, the heat should be reduced to simmering point.
Simmering point?
This is the way of cooking in which the food being cooked in hot liquids is kept just below the boiling point of water.
Which is 100 degrees centigrade.
Yes, and to do that, first bring the food to a boiling point, which is 100 degrees, then reduce the heat to a point where formation of bubbles has almost stopped, typically about 94 degrees Celsius.
Another question.
Uh-huh.
While boiling foods, what skill do you use to ensure the food is well cooked and the soup is just right in terms of quantity and quality?
Are you sure you don't want to be a chef someday?
I don't know.
Anyway, the proper way to make soup or stock or even sauce is by browning the food before they are cooked in the liquid for hours.
In English, please.
You are funny. Browning is the process of food turning brown due to chemical reactions that take place within it. It is usually done using oil or dry heat until it produces a delicious crust. From here, you can make sauce or stock before you boil the meat for hours.
I think maybe if you could demonstrate it down in the kitchen, I will understand it fully.
Sure. In fact, in a short while, I'll be walking you around to see some of our delicacies. Last rule for boiling foods is that seasoning should be added to the boiling water. All right, I know what you are thinking. Seasoning is simply adding spices like Royco to food to enhance taste or flavor.
I like Royco. So, my take is that boiling is simpler way of cooking food compared to stewing?
I think that's a rash judgment. But still, I must admit that boiling requires less attention when cooking compared to other cooking methods. Plus, the liquid used for boiling foods can also be used to make stock, sauce, or gravies for serving meals so that nothing goes to waste and no nutrients are lost. And finally, it comes in handy when modern cooking equipment are lacking.
Nice. Any reason I should prefer stewing to boiling?
Just one. Prolonged boiling can spoil the food in terms of taste, color, and nutrients. Come, let me show you around.
Sawa sawa.